You're listening to the Kitchen Invitation Podcast. Welcome back to your kitchen. Whether you're sick of food rules ruling your kitchen or you want to cook better meals and don't know where to start, you're in the right space. I'm your host and a registered dietitian, Jessie Holden. I like making cooking and nutrition livable, doable, and most importantly, fun. In my community, I'll help you make your own secret sauce to reframing your mindset, cook with confidence, and learn a ton along the way. Are you ready? Then grab your apron and let's get cooking.
Are you a New Year's resolution person, or do you hate New Year's resolutions? Personally, I like looking into the next year while also reflecting on the current one. I always tend to get nostalgic around this time of year. I start looking through my photos and I feel a sense of excitement for a new year to come, which is actually the same way I feel about August. I know that's not even like the true halfway mark of the year, but it's back to school season then. And I get that same kind of exciting feeling about a clean start, a new season. Like I love that sensation or that feeling. I don't like all the advertisements that come with New Year's resolutions, but we can get into that another time. So today I want to give you 5 fresh cooking goals to set yourself up for success in the kitchen this coming year. I'll also share my check-in method near the end that you can use to assess, reassess, and adjust your goals easily. But first, a quick thank you to my current Healthy Kitchen community members for their support. If you don't know, the group is designed to bring excitement back to the kitchen while you learn to cook for your own wellness. I help translate health and science into delicious meals, tasty cooking demos, educational lessons, and so much more every single week. I hope to see you there. You can find the link below in the show notes or on my site, thekitcheninvitation.com. Okay, let's start out with why many New Year's goals don't end up working out. First of all, they end up being really extreme. They often involve restriction. They're all or nothing. And they also are typically not checked in on and adjusted day to day or week to week. And really, I find one of the biggest culprits of why they don't work is because we don't show ourselves compassion. I'm not saying it's hopeless, but it is really important to set yourself up for success. And no, I promise I'm not going to define the SMART goal acronym for you. I'm kind of over that acronym anyways. We do need realistic goals, but more importantly, these goals have got to be behavior oriented. And honestly, it's more about the steps that you're going to take that you want to take to get to the goal than anything else. And yes, I said wanting to take, not needing to take. If you start a goal with, for example, I need to cook healthier, you are pre-guilting yourself. Not only is it harder to work through that mindset and get through that guilt to get to a goal, but it's also a lot less fun. Need to, shoulds, shouldn'ts, ought to, have to, they are all the same. And while they are all very normal parts of our language, they are not helpful. They keep us from developing a healthy relationship with food, movement, wellness, cooking, and even ourselves as a whole. Be gentle on yourself if you hear yourself saying them. Becoming aware of them is the first step to getting them out of your typical language and self-talk. So, what are my 5 fresh goals for you in your kitchen this year? I will list them out, but just know you can take on all 5 of these or pick one. Here we go. Number 1, gut your kitchen. Yep, you heard me. Gut it out, reorganize, and refresh it. If you've got cluttered countertops and cupboards, gut them out. clean the fridge and the freezer too while you're at it. And you know what? If you're cleaning all day, get the dishwasher clean too. It doesn't mean you need to throw away your food. Just getting a clean and fresh start ahead of you in the kitchen is going to help it feel like a blank canvas. So while this could be a 2023 goal, maintaining it is going to be like the overall yearly goal. But really, this is just the first goal, and I highly recommend you start with this one, no matter what any other goal is that you have for your cooking, meals, the kitchen, etc. Number two, ask yourself what you actually want to eat. It is so easy to go on autopilot with meals and to feel nourished, but maybe not always satisfied. And honestly, that's pretty normal and okay. But think about some really delicious food or a meal that you had in the past, or food that you'd really like to try. Find a recipe or a method of making it and set aside a night, maybe once a month, where you take the time to try. Not only is this a fun way to expand your palate and your skills, but it's also a really fun adventure you can take your whole family on too. I call this my to-cook list. I also have a bake list that you probably heard about that in the baking episode I did recently. And I keep ideas in there of foods that I really want to try cooking, but I have to do those recipes and those cooking techniques on a night that I have a really clear schedule and a good headspace around cooking. And that's not every night, so kind of set myself up for success by a running list, but maybe once a month tackling one of those things. Number three, try at least 12 new plants this year. So that could be one a month, right? 12 months, one new plant a month. I think it's doable. Maybe you've had them before, but maybe it's been a really long time, or maybe you just want to try cooking them in a new way. You know, Brussels sprouts are super different from steamed to roasted to air fried to shredded and sauteed. There's so many different ways to eat them. So even if it's not a completely brand new plant for you to try eating, maybe it's just a method of how you make them. It could be vegetables, fruits, plant proteins, you name it. It'll be a great way to increase your plant intake, but again, a way to expand your palate. This is definitely one of my goals this coming year. I will be experimenting with jackfruit, tempeh, more with tofu. I'm pretty familiar with it, and I've been having a lot more practice with it lately, but I definitely want to make it a goal to experiment a little further with it. I want to do something with rutabagas, and honestly, I'd like to just visit a lot of new greens. One I really enjoy is bok choy, and I haven't had it in so long because I haven't focused on, you know, expanding what I do in the kitchen. I am busy, and I mean, 99% of us are busy, right? And so I get on autopilot too, and I really want to revisit these specific plants and bring them into my cooking in one way, shape, or form. I know I didn't list 12 out, but I haven't figured out all 12 yet, but I'll get there. This is a fun goal for me. I think it'd be a really fun one for you as well. And there is a huge world of plants out there. You just have to look for them. Number four, get comfortable with recipe swaps. I am not saying to healthify your recipes, but learning to swap ingredients for budget and inventory sake is a really helpful skill. Y'all know I am very big into inventory systems for your food. I must mention it now on most of my podcast episodes, but that is so that you can cook more of what you already have at home. And if you missed the Black Friday sale, you know, way back in November, just a reminder that my ebook, which will help you create an inventory system and a step-by-step guide, and it does way more than that. It's over 30 pages. The link for that is in the show notes below. Okay, I digress. Learning to make swaps for ingredients can start with even just different kinds of veggies than called for in a soup. Swapping fresh for dried seasonings or powdered spices. So doing fresh garlic versus garlic powder. Nothing wrong with garlic powder, but your flavors and the food that you're cooking it with maybe it'll taste different and you'll find you really like the fresh garlic, or you get a little bit more antioxidants that way. Maybe you try to vary the oils that you're using and cooking with. Maybe you try to make your own dressing. So what this does is open your eyes and your mouth to cooking eventually without a recipe. That is something I'm going to be helping you with throughout 2023. That's like a big business goal for me, and I'll save it for another day as far as what that's going to look like. But as much as I love recipes, I also know sometimes we just don't have time and we want to get something on the table that's nutritious, delicious, and easy, right? So this is a great first step in getting there. So experiment, and don't forget to write down your observations when you're making some swaps for this or that, or you're adding a little bit of this, or you're sprinkling in a little bit of that. You want to write down those observations. It's going to boost your confidence when you try to cook completely without a recipe. The last fresh cooking goal I have for you today, number 5, is to cook from what you have on hand without a recipe, right? So sure, the first time you do this, it could be sauteed peppers with eggs and black beans and a tortilla. That still counts, not a recipe. So build up slowly to making cooking on a whim easier, and let yourself make a mess and have some fun. I know that kind of goes hand in hand with number 4, but I guess what I mean with number 5 is really utilizing your inventory system. So even if you're not cooking a full-on meal or snack with the food you have on hand, I encourage you that when you're cooking, you're also kind of giving your fridge one quick glance over to make sure you don't have any ingredients that need to get used up that you could happen to throw in there. Let's say you've got half a bell pepper that you used on Monday and it's Thursday and you're making a stir fry. You can probably chop the other half of that bell pepper and throw it in. If you don't want to, you could also take that bell pepper out. You could cut it in whatever way you want, throw it in a Ziploc baggie and freeze it, and then you could use it in the future. Any way to help you reduce food waste and use more of those fresh ingredients you have on hand, whether it's making your own meal recipe without a recipe, or you're just adding things in to use up more of what you have. I guess the overall goal of number 5 is to reduce food waste by using what you have on hand. So if you are in the Healthy Kitchen community already, again, link is in the show notes, you will also get 10 other goals in January that you could consider switching up and adding to your list, as well as adding added support and accountability if desired. So if you are someone listening right now and you're not in that community group and you're thinking, yeah, I think I do want to set some fun goals this year, but I do want more support, I encourage you to join me there. So now that you've heard my fresh goals for you this coming year, how do we check in on them and adjust them moving forward? I hope you stuck around for this part. 4 more steps to consider, okay? Number 1, first, establish the goal and write it down. Number 2, assess your why and also write down the long-term reasons why you want to achieve this goal, or what benefit you hope to get from achieving and working toward this goal. It's not just the goal itself. I encourage you to seek out and think about the benefits of working toward that goal. How would it make you feel? What would the impact be? I think sometimes focusing more on the steps and the process and enjoying it is even better than just focusing on the quote unquote end goal. Because to be honest, a lot of goals don't have an end, especially when it comes to cooking. We're going to eat every day. You may eat out and not have to cook every day, but you're going to be in the kitchen. So these are goals that are going to be kind of endless in a sense. Number 3, schedule a time to check in on yourself with the goal mentally and use a notepad. Physically write down how things are going. I really encourage you to do that. I suggest at least a weekly check-in in January and February, but sometimes monthly can be okay, just a once a month check-in. But to be honest, a month is a really long time to go without checking in on yourself. So schedule these as you would a doctor's appointment. Hell, do it daily if you want to. Add it to your calendar, set reminders ahead of time, and set secondary reminders and alarms too if you need that. Call it you time and follow my script in the next step. Number 4. Here is the step that has to happen during your check-in. A. What is working well for my goal? What are the successes I'm having? B. What obstacles have I faced and or are going to face? What are some solutions to those challenges? C. How do I feel physically and mentally? D. Do I want to adjust the goal to make it more livable, doable, and fun? E. How are my base wellness needs going? Is this the right goal for me right now? And F. If you adjust, stop, or change the goal entirely, remember not to shame yourself. This is critical. No judgment toward how that goal is going or how it could change. No judgment, period. If you find yourself thinking that way, then become aware of it and really try to reframe that judgmental thought. The more you can show yourself compassion and evolve with your goal, the less you're going to feel like, oh, I failed. See, I do this every year. I'll just, you know, start over on Monday, right? So lastly, I just want to remind you, because this is me coming from the place of I'm seeing all of the diet culture advertisements and things popping up in the stores that normally are in like the back corner. So I want to remind you, even if we all cooked the same and ate the same, we'd still all look different. You are doing great. Please do not overhaul your entire eating regimen, which is, as many of us know, leads to burnout, guilt, shame, and continuously being stuck in that restrict binge eating diet cycle. So, what freshy goals are you thinking of setting for yourself this year? I'd love to hear about them. I'd love to help. Pop over into my DMs on Instagram or over in the Healthy Kitchen community where you have full access to me. But until next year, happy cooking, everybody. Have a great New Year's Eve and New Year's Day. And I will see you all next year in the kitchen.